Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. There has been some positive movement on the electricity front this past week in a bit. Terence Grimmer joins me to unpack these developments. Hi, Terence.
Hi, Chanel.
The big news is that NERSA has concurred with a ministerial determination that paves the way for the resumption in regular procurement.
That's correct. This determination, or the concurrence with this determination, has been long awaited. The Minister of Mineral Resources and Energy, Gwede Mantashe, delivered this ministerial determination to NERSA in February for its concurrence. And we hear now that on the 2nd of September, the regulator has concurred with it, which opens the way for procurement of over 11,000 megawatts of new electricity generation divided between several different technologies, the largest being onshore wind, followed by solar photovoltaic, and then also gas to power some new coal, as well as energy storage. So with this determination, South Africa can now move into a new era of regular procurement. The last time we procured any new electricity from large-scale independent power producers was all the way back in 2014. And then we remember that there was a period of an impasse where the contracts for those 27 power plants weren't signed for a number of years. In fact, the deadlock was only broken in 2018 by the then Minister of Energy, Jeff Kadebe, and that happened only after a change in the administration where we saw Jacob Zuma leave the presidency and Cyril Ramaphosa assume it. So this is a major milestone in the area of IPP procurement, and it hopefully signals that some positive momentum is building.
Eskom has also signaled its support for this ministerial determination. Why is that significant?
Well, it's significant because the last time Eskom didn't support the program, that was back in 2015, the entire program came to a halt. And that's because Eskom is the single buyer of electricity from independent power producers. Now, there has been some debate, given its perilous financial position, whether it would remain the single buyer for the next rounds. But it looks like that Eskom is going to be the single buyer at this stage. It has been set up as a single buyer for the risk mitigation IPP program, which is currently in the market. And if it is the single buyer for the utility scale IPP arising from the determination that has just been concurred with by NERSA, then it should start a process of seamlessly getting back into procurement without many delays, without having to change the buyer model. So I think it's important both for the pace of the new procurement, as well as for having some certainty that this big monster or this giant in the system, Eskom, is not going to be an impediment to the purchasing of new IPP power.
What should we expect next?
Well, I think that all eyes are now going to be looking towards the release of the bid documentation, especially for the next renewable bid window. Now, we've had a number of bidding rounds up to bid window 4, which was procured, the 26 projects under that, which are currently under construction. Plus, we had the concentrated solar power only round, bid window 3.5, which was also delayed, and that project is now under construction. So we need to see now what is in the bid documentation and whether there have been major changes since we last procured in 2014. So I think there'll be eager anticipation to see what that documentation looks like. There's an indication from the DMRE and the political task team overseeing Eskom that we should see some movement and some visibility of that bid documentation before year end. This is ahead of the initial indications that were provided by the IPP office that we'd probably only see bid documentation for bid window 5 of the renewables and any other technologies such as gas to power, coal, storage happening only in 2021, towards the end of the first quarter. So that is good news. There seems to be some action around getting movement around procurement again. And then the important thing thereafter is whether we can sustain regular procurement, because if we had, we wouldn't have load shedding.
Thank you. That's the Second Take show for this week. Thank you for watching and join us again next time for more news analysis. Also, don't forget to listen to the audio version of our Engineering News Daily Email Newsletter.